In 2017, I was able to get a 2-book deal from Penguin Random House, which is the largest publisher in the world. And that was a moment of just complete shock and surprise. And I thought, if this is gonna happen for me and my book, I really need to work hard to make sure that I elevate this book to the level I know it can be at. Of the 11 short stories in Sabrina and Corina, they all are set in Colorado. I wanted to explore the city from different vantage points. I come from a family that's been in Colorado for many generations. I grew up in North Denver, and we were always just driving all over the city, and I was absorbing all these different sights and sounds and the textures of what it meant to come from this supposedly little cow town. Every story is focused on a female protagonist, which was also very important to me. I come from a family of six, it's 5 sisters, 1 brother, so there's 7 of us total. I always have to like count. And when people ask me, why would you write a book all about women? I'm like, that's all I know. I know a lot of women. Like, our lives should be centered and they should be the focus. So I wanted a book that explored Denver, that explored our histories in this incredibly feminine way. But I also wanted to show that this is an old city with a lot of history.
I think I read it in about 2 days total, and then almost got like anxious or panicky about it because I was like, this is such a beautiful book about our city, and it's so representative of our city. And this is our responsibility to get her to the library, to get this book in everybody's hands. So I just felt so excited when I finished it that I needed to spread the word to everyone I possibly could.
When I think of Kweli's work, I think there's a gap in the literary world of Denver, sort of literary West, especially when it comes to Latinos. And it's generally, you know, cowboys, farmers, that type of narrative. To then think about like Denver at that 70s, 80s, 90s, like, is a legitimate city. And nobody is really writing about Denver as a city, and specifically even then Latinos in the city. Kweli's work is, in recent memory, one of the first books that I can think of that kind of puts us on that storytelling map.
The official history when I would go to school was very different. It was all about, you know, European Americans coming from the East and pushing, but my ancestors came from the South and pushed up into Denver. So I was trying to have a dialogue with history and the current day reality of Denverites in a way that centered Chicanos.
This book really, for me, emphasizes the power of books, of connecting and developing empathy through reading. It really encompassed that all for me.
When Sabrina and Corina was longlisted and then became a finalist just recently for the National Book Award, I mean, I just wept. And I wept because I wanted to show people where I come from that this is possible, that you can write books that are going to be celebrated on the international stage. And not only that, I hope that it shows other Denverites and other people from this region that you can imagine yourself into these triumphs. I'm hoping that I will set an example and there'll be so many more writers from Colorado coming behind me who are able to have their books celebrated on the world stage.
It makes me so proud to be able to have this book out in the world and have other people see our city is an amazing thing. I think we're maybe a smaller city in the scale of things. There's not as much literature as there is about maybe New York City, so it is extra special seeing Denver in the limelight.
I am deeply passionate about representing our state, and I think you'll see a lot more books from me about Colorado in the future. I don't have any other interest. Like, I love our state and I love writing about it.